This video is about hormone therapy, ADT, and your bones. This video is the fourth of five short videos on bones and advanced prostate cancer. I'm not a doctor. I'm just a man with locally advanced, recurrent prostate cancer. I ask the questions. An expert medical oncologist answers the questions. And when you occasionally hear this sound, our resident artist attempts to illustrate. Meet the doctor.
My name is Alicia Morgans, and I'm an assistant professor of medicine at Vanderbilt University in Nashville, Tennessee, in the United States.
Why is testosterone important to prostate cancer cells?
Testosterone is the food or the fuel that those prostate cancer cells need to grow, spread, and survive.
How does hormone therapy, ADT, help?
So hormonal therapy, or ADT, takes testosterone levels down so low that it starves those cells and hopefully causes many of them to die or at least shrivel up and hibernate so they're not going to cause a problem.
Are there side effects when hormone therapy lowers a man's testosterone?
When we lower testosterone with hormonal therapy or ADT, men do experience side effects.
What might some of these side effects be?
This is the main male hormone. And when we lower it, we can see things like hot flashes or changes in sex drive that can be very disturbing for men.
Is hormone therapy for men like the menopause for women?
Some men think of it as the male version of menopause, what women experience as they get older. And in some ways, it's similar.
But is it the same thing?
But it is truly its own thing. And particularly the sexual side effects that men can experience can be somewhat troubling.
Are there any other side effects when hormone therapy lowers a man's testosterone?
Bones can thin and be at risk for fracture. There can be an increased risk of heart disease and an increased risk of things like diabetes.
So, with these possible problems, why is hormone therapy so widely used?
Despite all of that, hormone therapy, or ADT, is actually the best medicine that we have for treating prostate cancer, and it's the backbone of the treatments that we give.
What goes on in normal bones?
Normal bones are continuously being rebuilt and broken down. That's the normal life cycle of the bone.
What is the main mineral used to make bones?
Calcium is the main mineral that's used to build up bones, and vitamin D is sort of like the mortar that lets calcium enter into the bones and be incorporated into the bones themselves.
How does hormone therapy affect this normal recycling of bones?
Hormone therapy can affect the normal cycling of bone buildup and breakdown because this whole process is controlled by hormones.
Which hormone is very important for normal bone recycling, and how does hormone therapy affect this?
In particular, estrogens control that buildup and breakdown. And when we lower testosterone with hormonal therapy to treat prostate cancer, we're also lowering estrogen levels.
What is the effect of lower estrogen levels?
This causes the bones to break down more than they build up, and it causes them to thin over time.
Yeah. How do we measure the strength of bones?
We can measure the thickness, which really reflects the strength of the bones, with something called a DEXA, or a bone density scan. It's generally just an x-ray that looks at how thick or dense the bones are, and it can relate it to the doctor in a number that tells the doctor how likely that bone is to fracture or to break.
When might a doctor recommend the bone mineral density scan, the BMD or DEXA scan?
The doctor might recommend the first DEXA scan early on in treatment when starting hormonal therapy, sometime within the first year or so of starting hormonal therapy.
Why might the bone mineral density scan be ordered before hormone therapy begins?
If the doctor is concerned that an individual may be at higher risk of having a break or a fracture or thin bones even before the hormone therapy has started, he or she might order that DEXA scan or bone density scan just as the hormonal therapy is beginning.
If the bones are thinning from the cancer or from the treatment, how can the doctor lower the risk of bones breaking?
If the doctor thinks that the bones have already become thin or are thinning during hormonal treatment for prostate cancer, the doctor can prescribe medicines like Zometa or denosumab to thicken the bones and strengthen them so that they are at lower risk of breaking.
Is there a role for exercise when a man is on hormone therapy?
When men have prostate cancer and are on hormonal therapy, there is always a role for using bodily activities like exercise and staying active to strengthen their bones. We always encourage men to be as active as possible because even walking, which is a weight-bearing activity, strengthens the bones. Believe it or not, even if you spend the day in bed, whether you have prostate cancer or not, or you're on hormonal therapy or ADT or not, your bones start to break down. So just getting up and walking strengthens your bones and helps to keep them stronger.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This video is the fourth of five short videos on bones and advanced prostate cancer. Look for the other four videos, which deal with why bones are important in advanced prostate cancer, the special case of prostate cancer in the spine, treatment for prostate cancer in the bones, and a special message on pain. If you want to see more videos on advanced prostate cancer in the future, click on subscribe. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. It helps. Think anyone else might like this? Share it by email, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, whatever. There are links to more resources in the description below. Comments or suggestions are welcome below. Thanks for watching.